I'm Dr. Jamila Minga, and I study right hemisphere brain damage. Individuals have questioned why I study this. Ironically, I study question asking and right hemisphere brain damage. So I think the root of that question, why do you study right hemisphere brain damage, rests in the fact that when most people consider communication impairments, they think of left hemisphere brain damage. They think of communication impairments that result secondary to aphasia, or the aphasias, because there are multiple. In these individuals that have left hemisphere brain damage, oftentimes the communication is very overt, meaning that you can really, really tell with their speech production in particular, and also their comprehension, that they are not understanding or able to produce the language in the speech. Right hemisphere brain damage, and after a right hemisphere stroke, the individuals can produce the speech and language on the surface. What distinguishes the communication impairment is that they often have challenges when it comes to production with pragmatic aspects of communication. Now, these are aspects of communication that have to do with knowing what to say, when to say it, and how to say it. If they do have a right hemisphere stroke, oftentimes the rehabilitation period is very short. It's very brief. So they are often discharged within the community, but their relationships may fail, their jobs may fail, and so there are real kind of functional consequences to our lack of awareness concerning specifically the communication after a right hemisphere stroke. My lab is working really hard to assist with enhancing knowledge, understanding, diagnosis, and treatment options. And so, that question of why the right hemisphere kind of rests in our ability to really, really, you know, come to realize that communication deficits occur after damage to both hemispheres. And it's my work to increase awareness concerning these communication impairments.